Good morning everyone, this video is for the students of class 11th, subject economics, class 12th, forms of market, and this is our chapter from microeconomics, and this is our lecture number 1 for this chapter. So in this chapter we are going to read about forms of market. So there are 4 forms of market. First one is perfect competition, second one is monopoly, third one is monopolistic competition, and fourth one is oligopoly. So in this video we are going to read about perfect competition market. Okay, so what is perfect competition market? Perfect competition market is a form of market where there is a large number of buyers and sellers of a commodity. Okay, it means that in such competitive market we are dealing in one commodity and there are large number of buyers and sellers of that commodity. In such market, homogeneous product is sold and its price is determined by forces of supply and demand. An individual buyer and seller has no control over the price. Okay, so in perfect competitive market, the firm is price taker, not price maker. The price is decided by market forces of supply and demand, and firm has to take that price. Okay. Now, the features of such market are, first one is large number of small buyers and sellers of that commodity. Okay, in such market there are large number of buyers and sellers of a commodity such that an individual seller cannot influence the market price. An individual buyer cannot influence the market price. Price is determined by market forces and uniform price prevails in the market. Okay, so the first feature of such market is that in such kind of market, large number of small buyers and sellers of a commodity are there, and they are so large that one single seller or one single buyer cannot influence the market price. They cannot change the market price. They have to take the price which is prevailing in the market. Okay, so price is determined by market forces. No individual seller or no individual buyer can affect the market price. So as a result, uniform price prevails in market. Okay, now next feature is homogeneous product. What do you mean by homogeneous product? It means that product sold in the market is identical. Identical in terms of size, identical in terms of shape, identical in terms of looks. Okay, there is zero degree of product differentiation, means no difference is there among those products. No firm can charge high price for product. Okay, in such kind of market we are dealing for homogeneous product, so as a result no firm can charge high price for that product, as goods can be easily substituted. Because if one firm will charge high price, then customers or buyers will shift to another firm. So as a result no firm can charge high price. That's why a single price or uniform price prevails in such kind of market. Third type of feature is perfect knowledge. In such kind of market, the buyers and sellers are fully aware about the prevailing price in the market. Okay, so producers cannot charge different prices from different buyers. Okay, they cannot differentiate the buyers and they cannot charge high price. Why? Because every buyer has perfect knowledge about the price of the commodity. So they knew that the price of the commodity is that. So that's why sellers cannot charge high price. Next one is freedom of entry and exit. Freedom of entry and exit means a new firm is free to enter such industry and an existing firm is free to leave it. Okay, so because of this feature, freedom of entry and exit, the firm earns normal profit under perfect competitive market. Okay, this will be explained later on. See, now next one is independent decision making. Independent decision making means there is no agreement between any two firms regarding quantity to be produced or price to be charged. In such kind of competitive market, firms do not form trust or cartels. Cartels means agreement between two firms, okay, regarding the price. So in such kind of market, perfect competitive market, firms has to adopt the prevailing price. They cannot change the price and they cannot form any agreement and they cannot change the prevailing price. So that's why we can say that in such kind of competitive market, firms do not form trust or cartels and they do not have independent decision making power. Okay. Now, the next feature of perfect competitor market is perfect mobility. Perfect mobility means factor of production. What are the factors of production? Land, labor, capital, entrepreneurs. They are perfectly mobile. They can move to that industry where they get higher price. Okay? Suppose let us talk about labor. Now, in such kind of competitive market, laborers are free to move to that place where they can get higher wages, higher salary. Okay? So, there is perfect mobility of factors of production. Next one is no extra cost. No extra cost means in such kind of market, we do not add advertisement cost and selling cost. Okay, a producer can sell his product at any place and a buyer can buy it from the place he likes. So only one price prevails in the market and there are no transportation cost and selling cost. Okay. Now, whatever we have read about perfect competitive market, we can draw three conclusions. What are those conclusions? A firm is a price taker, not a price maker. Okay, it says that in perfect competitive market, firm is price taker. He takes the price. He is not price maker. Okay, price is determined by forces of market demand and market supply. A firm sells its output at the given price. Okay, whatever price is determined by the market forces, the firm has to sell its output at that given price. Therefore, a firm under perfect competitive market is a price taker, not a price maker. Okay. Now, what are the reasons for this? The first reason is large number of firms. As we know that in such kind of market, there are large number of sellers and buyers. Okay. Now, we know that there are large number of firms. So, if any one firm charges any high prices for the commodity, okay, suppose one firm charges high price for the commodity, then having perfect knowledge, buyers can shift to another firm. So, it will lead to loss for that firm, the firm which is charging higher prices. So, that is why no firm can charge higher price. Second reason is homogeneous product. Okay, we are dealing in such kind of products in such market which can be substituted easily. Okay, if I am purchasing one product from one firm and that firm is charging higher prices, then I can easily purchase that product from any other firm, the firm which will give me that product at the prevailing price. So in such case, the producers cannot charge higher price from the consumer. Okay, and as a result, the firm has to take the price which is prevailing in the market. And the third reason is perfect knowledge. As I said, buyers have perfect knowledge and they have complete knowledge about the prevailing price. So they know that whatever the price is prevailing in the market, so they cannot be exploited by the producers. Okay. So these are the reasons for the conclusion that firm is a price taker, not a price maker. Now, if you remember in revenue chapter, we read that AR is equal to MR curve under perfect competitive market. So, this from there we can derive that demand curve in perfect competitive market is perfectly elastic. If we change the price, if we charge the price higher or if we lower the price, then our demand will fall suddenly to zero. Okay. So, in such kind of market, price is constant and demand keeps on changing. Okay, so we can say that the elasticity of demand is perfectly elastic. Okay, now the third conclusion is that a firm earns only normal profit in long run. See, I said that we will learn this later on when I say that every firm has freedom to exit and freedom to entry. Okay, so because of that reason, a firm earns only normal profit in long run under perfect competitive market. See how. Suppose there are extra normal profits in the market. Now, if there are extra normal profits, then new firms will join with the motive of earning profit. Now, as new more firms will join, market supply of that commodity will increase. Now, supply will increase, then market price will fall and extra profit will be wiped off. Okay, so ultimately the firm will reach to normal profit. Now suppose there are extra normal losses. If extra normal losses are there, then the existing firm will leave the industry. some firms will leave. Now, when existing firms will leave, market supply will fall because as number of firms will decrease, supply will also decrease. Now, as supply will decrease, market price will rise because demand is same but supply is decreasing. So, price will rise. As price will rise, extra normal loss will disappear. Okay, so these are the two reasons that in under perfect competitive market, we earn only normal profit. We do not earn extra normal profit or extra normal losses. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. So your homework is that you have to learn this perfect competition market, in which you have to learn its definition, its features and three vital conclusions. Okay.